Dynamite, I got the idea. I got the original idea for the track while I was in the gym. I was working out, which obviously you can tell I do. No, I was working out and I was like, holy shit, I have the best idea for like a melodic, I hear a piano doing like this thing like dun 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 dun. And then I was like, it'd be real cool if the drum followed, like boo 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 boo. And then I was like, and then it should go to like, you know, just this like, just like a straight dance beat, but it should be completely like broken up and airy as fuck. Like I picture everyone just doing ecstasy right there, like, you know, that's like the breakdown where everyone's just like getting low, getting low, getting low, and then just bam.
I throw my hands up in the air sometimes, saying ayo, gotta let go.
What do you think we should do that?
Let's play a little bit.
Alright. Cause I'm gonna double that with keyboard. Wait, like. So if you go. There we go. You go. Okay. Neon is an artist that I work with. She's extremely talented. She's been touring her ass off, you know. She's got a pretty good online following. And, you know, basically we're putting out an EP before the actual album comes out. We want people, you know, to get to know Neon a little bit.
That's pretty sweet.
Wake up in the morning feeling like P. Diddy.
Hey, what up, girl?
Grab my glasses, I'm out the door. I'm gonna hit this city.
Me, Luke, and Dr. Luke and Kesha wrote the song. I had a drum beat that I was working on the day before, and, you know, Luke had a cool synth line, and, like, you know, the beat came pretty quickly. The beat just happened. It came. And then, you know, Kesha came in and we're like, and we were just talking about stuff, and me and Kesha were just like starting to come up with verse ideas, and we're like, what if the first line said something about Puff Daddy? And we're just like, oh my God, that'd be so ridiculous. And then Luke was like, well, you should say Diddy, because that's what his name is. And then we were like, we should just call the song P. Diddy. And the song was originally called P. Diddy for like months. So we're like, and then, like, after, we were like, dude, we have to get Puff Daddy, or P. Diddy on it, or Diddy, whatever, or Puff, whatever he's going by right now. But, yeah, no, Diddy actually got on it in the end. Like, that's him saying that. Claude Kelly, he's a genius, and he has a voice of a baby angel. And, he's great, man. We've worked on Catcher together. We also wrote for Britney Spears together, and without him, the songs would not be the songs that they are. You know, he is amazing. And we were writing, me, him, and Neon, we were writing for an outside artist. You know, you never really know, you know. A lot of times you're in the studio with the people, but, you know, sometimes you come up with ideas beforehand. And it could be something that we start with Britney. It could be something that we do with, you know, that we do with Neon. It could be something that we do with, you know, a number of artists.
Check it out. Like, this is only like one, like there's no real parts yet, but it's, and there's literally like two sounds, but check it out. This would be like the pre, I think, or the beginning of the chorus. Pretty cool though. I don't know what it would do. There's nothing really in it.
Yeah, I'm ready.
And now you're coming
in. Put me in. Put me in. At the
not a donut, if you need a loan. I could be your don't raise it on the floor. I did not a don't with the no.
Like the words are there.
Come back and be totally fresh. Like, oh, duh. The song's called Toenail, duh. Like, listen, motherfucker. I see you got spin for air. Ooh, ooh, I should, but I just don't care. Today could be Britney, tomorrow could be Barbara Streisand.
I use Pro Tools HD. I use a lot of outboard gear. I use tons of vintage synths. The older, the better. And I'm not talking about like 5 years ago. I'm talking like 20, 30 years ago. Like a lot of the synths I have, you know, I mean, most of the synths I have, they don't even make anymore. And, you know, these are like 30-year-old synths. And, you know, I just like to, I don't want anyone to be able to be like, oh, I use that sound already. I want to have a weird sound. Like, that's why I use these old keyboards. I use toys from when I was a kid. And, you know, we mod them so you can plug an input in them to get sound. I just want everything to sound really different. I love using live instruments, you know. And I love everything to be real tight. Just real tight and compressed. No MIDI, no VSTs. One, because I'm fucking retarded and don't know how to use them. And two, because I want the real thing, baby.
Greetings, loved ones. Let's take a journey.
California Girls, we wrote, had some more people on it. That was me, Max, Luke, Snoop, and Bonnie McKee, and Katy Perry. Actually, I've just come into town. Me and Luke sat down, and we literally sat down in there's a big, huge studio, and then we have another setup. We always just have another setup for editing and just small writing in the other room. And we just went in the other room, and there was something happening in the main room, and we went in the other room. And it was literally the first beat we made. It took us like 10 minutes. And we made this thing in like 10, 20 minutes. And that became, you know, the song. You know, and then you know, Max came in and just killed melody. And then, you know, Katy and Bonnie are so talented at writing. And we all kind of just came together and put our heads together and just tried to make a song that just felt like California. I'm waiting for the day like where someone's gonna be like, all right, Benny, the jig's up, time to get a real job. You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Cause I really don't, man. You know, I promise you, I kid you not. Like, I literally just fuck around. Like, I don't know anything about the technical side. Like, it's all just, you know, trial and error, you know? And no, my plans for the future, I plan on doing this, man. I love music. I live, breathe, eat shit. I do, it's music. It's music. That's it, man. And it's just like, you know, I think anyone who does music should keep on doing music. I think anyone who does anything creative that can help change someone's life is fucking awesome. And that's what it's all about, man.